Hello, I'm Val, or Space Valkyries. I am a queer variety streamer and sci-fi fantasy writer, and this is my review of Lake. It's also my first full review ever, so you know. I hope you enjoy it.
I'm sure you'll do great.
Lake is a slightly unpolished, yet very charming, fun, and relaxed slice-of-life game set in small-town Oregon in 1986. You play as Meredith Weiss. Meredith is in desperate need of a break from her stressful programming job in the city, so she decides to take a two-week vacation in her hometown of Providence Oaks and deliver mail in place of her dad, who's on vacation down in Florida, apparently Alabama slamming it or something.
Alabama slammers, cheers!
I played the demo a couple months ago and really enjoyed it, so it felt appropriate for this to be my first full review on the channel. And full disclosure, I did get a code to stream this game on Twitch. Also, my reviews and opinions tend to be, here's what worked for me and here's what didn't. If you like or dislike similar things, you too might vibe with this content. Or not, in style. So there's no score system, because that just gives me anxiety. So I'll give what I liked and what I didn't, and ultimately if I recommend it or not overall. So let's get to it. Let's hop into this postal van and neum into the lake. I mean, what? Let's start with what I liked and felt worked really well. And overall, I really enjoyed this game, so buckle up, there's gonna be a lot. This game is gorgeous and soothing. The town is cute and charming, and I especially love the details of the movie titles of all the videos in the Flick Shack in particular. There's some really good ones in there. The lake, of course, is the mainstay of the game's aesthetic and really made me want to go on a trip to the Pacific Northwest. Seriously, it's just so pretty. The gameplay itself is pretty straightforward. Delivering mail is fun and satisfying. If you like open world, slice of life games where there's no combat and you're just vibing around in a postal van, driving questionably, you will likely enjoy how fun and relaxed delivering mail in this game is. There's no minigames, no timers, just you in a mailbox and maybe sometimes delivering parcels that are weirdly wrapped teddy bears. Now this next part is very important because it's like the mainstay of your time in the game, so it's important to acknowledge the elephant in the room. Or rather, the road. You're driving. The game absolutely knows what you do, and the wrong side of the road shenanigans and stopping entire lanes of traffic you get up to, and it said, yeah, this is kind of a bug at times. But it's also a feature, Skyrim style, and I love it. Your trusty postal van is no ordinary postal van. It's called the Goose.
The Goose? Yes, your white and wobbly van, duh.
And it can take no damage, fly into the lake only to respawn anew at the post office, drive into cutscenes, and so much more. Most of the time, the driving chaos was beautiful, hilarious, and the game kind of leaned into it. The Goose could go many places, hit many things, and roam through the fields of a farm freely, as postal vans should. This was easily the best part of the game for me, and I will forever cherish this immortal postal van and the time we shared together. Outside of gameplay, the dialogue was fun, sincere, and heartfelt. You do get some dialogue options and choices too, which was fun. Some of the characters are great and memorable as well. My favorite is Kay, who I related to a lot on the wasn't good enough to make it in college and questioned my self-worth for ages, but am now finding it again. It might be a little too real. The game's Steam page says Lake doesn't shy away from slice of life themes, and this is where that shines through really well. You just have these quiet but important moments, And those moments with Kay were actually my favorite scenes over most others, even over the romance scenes. Well, okay, there was one romance scene I liked more than others, but it's a spoiler, so you know. And yes, there's romance options. And I'll be honest with you, I don't actually know who the other romance options are. The lumberjack Robert might be one.
Great, I'm Robert. Nice to meet you.
But my bisexual self immediately focused on Angie. So yes, there's one queer romance option that I know of, or at least one women loving women option. There are options to end the budding romantic relationship if you want to, but I don't really know what those look like because I'm a romantic sap, and Angie was just very nerdy and adorable and sweet, and basically any and all interactions with her were endearing and deserve a whole section of this review because I'm but a simple bisexual, and I say so. Okay, thanks. You don't have to take any romance options if those don't interest you, though. I think, however, some characters might be a little like wink wink, so you're still interested in somebody, wink wink.
I'm glad we can have these adult conversations now.
But you can stay friends with Angie and Robert? Yeah, Robert. I'm so sorry, I keep forgetting his name.
Can you hear me now?
Because I'm still too bisexual about Angie, but yeah. I don't think it messes with the core plot of the game in any way. The romance is more of a subplot, and the main story is more focused on Meredith's choices, personal growth, and connection to others. One of the main points of the game is that you get to determine your own story. There are no right or wrong answers or endings, simply what you want to happen. And while obviously there's only so many paths and options the game can provide you, it really did frame the options as options with pros and cons, not morally good or bad. For example, at multiple points, your shitty boss Steve asks you to do work despite you being on a 2-week vacation. You can choose to ignore that, or do the work and focus on furthering your career. I chose to do the work and pursue my career because doing a lot of extra work for no pay is just a thing in my life. Content creation and being a writer is so rough sometimes, y'all.
Ooh. Ah, a writer. How interesting.
Every choice in the game you can choose to take or not. Do you reconcile with your childhood friend who really went through it while you were away and super consumed by making it in your career? Do you go back to your job, your career you've pushed yourself for so long? Or do you give up the fast-paced grind and move back to your sleepy but happy hometown? The game really does let you pick and really doesn't seem to judge you for it either way. It's pretty apparent there's a primary narrative amongst the options, though. Throw away the fast lane, city life, and ditch your awful corporate boss and soul-sucking grind. Stay in this small town and embrace a quieter, slower life, but a valid life nonetheless. And while the game doesn't try to label the options as good or bad, you're still supposed to be finding the rustic small town charm and appeal of slowing down. And when you pick your career options, the game will ask, are you sure? If you pick focus on my career, the game will be like, do you want to miss out on these human moments? Are you sure? Because life in the fast lane means missing out on these small moments that are really what make life so special. For me, since my whole career is very online TM, it was interesting sometimes to experience the unplug and get away from the evil internet vibes while I'm like playing this game and recording it all so I can make a review video on YouTube. There was a moment towards the end that really got me though. I often don't really know what the future looks like or what will work for me without causing me extra fatigue or pain. So I find myself looking at others and asking, how do you know what you're doing or what you want in life? And again, minimal spoilers, but there's a moment where Meredith echoes that sentiment in the game to Maureen, and the game kind of goes, I don't know, it's okay to not know what you want in life, but you have to pick something and try your best to live with the choices. And I don't know why, but I found that message very profoundly needed in this moment of my life. So good on you, game. That gave me a feeling. It's little moments like that that are the core part of the game and made it such a kind and chill experience, other than, you know, the goose. And now for the dislikes, which always makes me anxious to vocalize dislikes, but here goes. The dialogue, while engaging and great at times, was also a bit meh at others.
Realize all that a change can only come.
Oh, yes. But no. Sorry.
And some of the characters were also just meh, too. Like, why are you here? So when you combined that with the great character interactions and thoughtful moments, it was just so tonally inconsistent that I had a hard time. And on top of that, the cutscenes are unskippable. So if you want to go back and pick different options, or if you just don't want to deal with a specific character, it can be less than ideal. And again, no spoilers, I promise. But towards the end of the game, it also sort of felt like you could see the duct tape holding certain scenes together, which normally wouldn't bother me, especially in an indie game like this. But there were just some confusing inconsistencies, and I felt like the ending I got by pursuing a relationship with Angie just felt so out of character to what I picked with career options for the majority of the game. Mind you, none of these are deal breakers, and the positive interactions more than outweighed them, and the ending I got was genuinely sweet and super gay, and I was just like, aww. But a little rough. Not game-breakingly rough, but it did diminish how impactful my decisions overall were, just a little bit. But that's okay. I just went back to driving around, numing into the lake. I mean, what? On the whole, Lake is a charming experience, and one that I'd recommend if you're interested in calm, slice-of-life type games. It's not a perfect experience, but honestly, somehow that fits really well into the themes it's going for. Like, life isn't perfect. You make choices. Sometimes you like the results. Sometimes the results are confusing, and you just have to roll with it. And sometimes you deliver mail and block traffic with a postal van that can't take any damage. I mean, what? And that's it for my first ever full game review. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed it, be sure to like and subscribe. I post videos every other Thursday, or every Thursday if I'm having a good energy time. The chronic illness life. And if you want to support me, you can become a member on Ko-fi. And get sneak peeks and early access to videos, as well as monthly updates and other fun stuff. Till next time.